13 to fight armed groups in the Darfur region. It was later used in crackdowns on anti-government protests. The Rapid Support Forces led the response to rallies in Khartoum in June 29, 2019, in which 123 people were killed and hundreds were injured. Last month, talks between the paramilitary unit and the army failed to reach an agreement on when it would be integrated into the armed forces. The Rapid Support Forces say it needs 10 years, while the army wants only two. Well, joining us now from Khartoum is Mariam Almahdi, Sudan's former foreign minister. Give us your reaction to what's happening.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you very much for this interview in this critical time. I am here sitting in my house, listening to the voices of the exchange of armor, listening to the voice of the airplanes above the skies of Khartoum, the capital. And I really feel very sad and very angry. Actually, I'm enraged. And I say to both of them, shame on you, both of you. You have been entrusted for this great revolution, and you already committed a nonsensical coup. And we came back to our senses as Sudanese, rational people and wise leaders. And you again pledged that you will deliver back the power to the civilians. And now, while the civilian operation, the political operation, it is reaching towards its end, they come this eruption of this nonsensical war that is demonstrates again the how these two armed men regard the Sudanese people in as very low. This war needs doesn't need to come, because it takes two stupid, stubborn parties to go to war. Things were already agreed to be settled by dialogue. Already we have signed a paper of for security sector reform. It was first signed by both of them. Then the other civilian forces supported their agreement. So yes, this war was not at all anticipated, though we have been seeing how they have been deploying the troops from everywhere, how they have been confronting each other inside the neighborhoods of the civilian people and inside the capital, Khartoum. We thought this was just a show of power or show of force, because they have this ego, both of them, around themselves. But to take things to this level and to devastate the security of the civilians deliberately, like they did, both of them, this is absolutely shame on both of them. And this is a very serious failure in the political will. And the devastation now, or the devastation to the civilians' security inside their homes and in their side neighborhood will not go unpunished. It will not go in pardon. This is very serious thing done deliberately over several weeks. And now each of them is claiming that the other one started the war. And because it is shameful, of course, each one will deny it. But the truth will come very soon, at very high cost of Sudanese people bloods, at very cost of Sudanese people security and feeling of insecurity, as very high cost of defamation of Sudan as a country of a great revolution to be devastated like this. Really, it is something that is putting me really in a personal enrage, and I don't see the point, because both of them, they know no one can win. Sudanese armed forces is the national Sudanese forces, which is respected by everybody, which it is the forces that is assigned for the security of Sudan by the constitution. The Rapid Support Force is initiated and established by the Sudanese armed forces and actually by the previous regime, but they have done a great job in supporting the revolution. We know for the last at least 12 months, there have been huge comeback of the previous regime, the National Congress Party, the NCP, who have been inciting lots of anger, lots of lack of trust amongst and between the two of them, and also amongst the Sudanese public opinion, because they said, and they said that when they are out of power, they will, Sudan will be devastated. And actually, they are now actualizing their promise in this also very bad way, showing that the NCP, whatever we try to deal with them as countrymen and women having their citizenship, they were not harassed. They were not hanged.
Ma'am, I'd like to ask you about a point that you made earlier on. Forgive me for interrupting you, but you raised an interesting point about the impact that this is going to have in Sudan. Sudan, of course, is a country with a struggling economy. What do you think that the impact of this conflict, even though it lasts only perhaps for 24 hours or so, even if it's short-lived, what kind of impact is that going to have in Sudan?
Absolutely. Only the deployment was defaming Sudan. Only the deployment, even before they have now stopped the airport, and the Khartoum is totally disconnected and put into standstill. Before that, Sudan, as a promising land of many resources, as a very important strategic land connecting the Eastern Africa and the Western Africa, and making having great opportunities in agriculture. And now we are approaching into summer season of agriculture. All that they have really devastated it. And it is needless and it is nonsensical. Now already the Sudan security apparatus, they declared the Rapid Support Force as a rebel group, and that they are waging war against them. And the Rapid Support Force, they are saying they are defending themselves. We know that there have been so many challenges in that, but it was all addressed. And it was all within the reach of resolution, because everybody confesses that Sudanese armed force must be united. All the rapid support force must merge in Sudanese armed force. All the rebel groups who came, the militia of the warring party who came through the Juba peace agreement should all merge together, because this is a major call for the revolution. It's a major call for us in this political operation to have a one national professional army. This is our call. This is our commitment.
Mariam Almahdi, we appreciate you being with us on Al Jazeera. Forgive me for interrupting you. Unfortunately, time is against us. But Mariam Almahdi, Sudan's former foreign minister, ma'am, thank you very much indeed for being with us.